All right, so for C, I had two dipoles. I had one pulling away here, one pulling away there. Do these dipoles perfectly cancel out? Yes. So the answer is that I would have no net dipole, okay? So this is an example of, basically, think about that I had the sumo wrestler again, and then I'm like going up against him, but then check it out. Like my brother is here. Let's say, yeah, my brother's like looks just like me. And then I have another sumo wrestler there, and they're pulling against each other. So really, at the end of the day, what I have is two sumo wrestlers pulling against each other. It's just that I'm in between, like, getting torn apart, okay? So what I'm trying to say here is that overall, there's going to be no net dipole, even though there are dipole moments, because the dipoles perfectly cancel out. So there's no area where I would have a part of the molecule that has way more electrons. Okay? Cool. So then let's talk about D. D had two dipoles as well. It had one going in this direction, one going in this direction. Do they perfectly cancel out? No. So this would have a net dipole. Because of the fact that we're going to have a side of the molecule that always has more electrons than the other, and there's a disbalance. So what that means is that D does have a net dipole.